I sent Adam on a mission, and he succeeded. This week has just been the week of showing you my t-shirt as soon as I start a video, but it's unified that way. But today I'm answering a tag, an original tag that Rachel made up, and I will link Rachel's channel below. I love Rachel. She does amazing book reviews, and she has fabulous hair, and she made me an awesome If You're Traveling to London video when I was getting ready to go to London, which was life-saving just based on the escalator etiquette tip. That was life-saving. So Rachel's tag is all about matching up school subjects to a book, starting with maths, and I picked John Green's An Abundance of Catherines, which is actually my favorite John Green book besides The Fault in Our Stars, although I feel like you shouldn't even have to say that whole sentence. Just everyone assume The Fault in Our Stars is everyone's favorite John Green book. Come at me. You know that's true. Alright, but I immediately thought of An Abundance of Catherines because I thought of the little mathematical equation of being dumped, and so I kind of always put math with An Abundance of Catherines. Next is science, Jilly's subject, and Rachel picked science fiction, which I was like, yeah, duh, that's what I was thinking too. So I picked this book that I haven't actually read yet, called Alienated. I picked this up at the Southern Kentucky Book Festival when I went with Miss Cat, Cat of Diamonds, and I think it's just like a alien romance story, and I thought you don't see very many of those. Like, I liked The Host. I'm not gonna lie to you, I like The Host by Stephanie Meyer, so I thought, well, maybe this would have the same sort of vibe. So it must be some sort of science, biology, something. There's stars on the front. Science. For English, I picked Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, because you can't stop me from putting Harry Potter in every single book tag thing ever. But I picked Harry Potter not because they are English and they speak English, but because you have to learn vocabulary for those Harry Potter books. You know, you're learning all the words for these spells and all these words for these things that come from a different world that you're not used to. So I immediately think, like, vocabulary, and I'm always amazed. That is, like, one of my most favorite parts about the Harry Potter series is just that J.K. Rowling has built this whole world with this whole new set of vocabulary, and I could go on about it forever, you know this. The next subject is art, and, you know, I'm kind of partial, and I picked another book from another of my favorite series, and that is The Girl Who Circumnavigated Fairyland in a Ship of Her Own Making, and I originally bought this book because of the cover art and because of the art, the chapter art at the beginning of each one. Let me see if I can find the beginning of a chapter. Which really drew me in, and I really didn't know anything about the story, and I was like, I just love the art on this, so, I made a couple videos about that series, and it's my mission to get everyone to read that. Between that and The Nerd Circus, I wish. Language is the next subject, and I picked the Dictionary of Australian Phrase and Fable that my lovely Australian goddaughters, Miss Amy and Miss Sarah, sent me and marked lots of good Australian slang for me. I actually did a video on this when they first sent it to me, trying to guess what different Australian phrases might mean before I read what it meant, and I just flipped to my favorite one, the first one Amy ever taught me about, and that is drop bears. I will never forget Amy telling me about drop bears and tricking me about drop bears. The second to last one is history, which I kind of took as like history social studies, and I picked Wicked, which I'm so proud of my Wicked. It's like probably the original cover, if not, like close to it, and it's real beat up. You can tell I've read it many times, and it's so good, and it's a book I feel like you have to read a couple times, and I picked it for history or social studies because if you've only seen the musical of Wicked and you've never read this, you're missing out. It's very different, and this is actually very political and really, really intense and interesting to read, so I highly recommend if you've only ever seen the musical and you've never read Wicked to, like, buckle down and read Wicked because it's so good. It's so good. Lena knows. The very last subject is geography, and Rachel said it should be a book that you have that is set not in the UK or the US, and I was like, I don't know if I even have any of those, so I kind of cheated on this one, and I picked my collection of Douglas Adams books because they start out on Earth for a minute and then the UK, but then mostly they're in space. And space different than the US or the UK. I need to get this on my Kindle because I want to reread this, but like, this is all I'm getting. I think I've talked about that before. Rachel, thank you for tagging me. I would like to tag my, you know, top favorite booktubers, Miss Nancy, Miss Allie, Miss Katie. I think maybe you knew that was coming because you're my fave booktuber people. All right, so Jilly and other lovely viewers as well. I will talk to you later. Bye.